Good morning, I'm Eric Scott. This is New Jersey's First News for Friday, February 4th. It is mostly rain that is falling across the Garden State this morning, although our chief meteorologist Dan Zero says eventually it will change into a wintry mix, and there may be a period of icing late tonight. All of the details about that and your weekend weather on air, online at nj1015.com and on our free mobile app. COVID metrics in the Garden State are about as low as they've been since the start of the pandemic 2 years ago. The number of new reported COVID cases is a fraction of what they were just 2 weeks ago. Further evidence the Omicron wave is ending. Hospitalizations, about 2,300 this morning, but the majority of those were admitted for something else and then tested positive for COVID. Towns that had implemented indoor mask mandates in December as the Omicron wave was really first starting to wash over New Jersey are now letting them expire. That's already happened in East Brunswick and New Brunswick. Today, the indoor mask mandates expire in Princeton and Asbury Park. However, Newark and Montclair are going in the opposite direction. They're extending their indoor mask mandates at least into next month. We've told you pressure continues to mount from both Republicans and Democrats for Governor Murphy to roll back remaining pandemic restrictions in the Garden State, but it remains unclear whether Murphy will extend the current public health emergency beyond next week when it expires, or if the legislature will act to curb his power. I write more about that this morning at nj1015.com. Republicans, meanwhile, are launching a new social media campaign they call Give It Back. Republican state senators hoping to push Murphy to drop pandemic rules around vaccines and masks, and maybe even cut taxes or raise rebates to return a projected windfall in tax revenues back to taxpayers. It may be the end of the snow day in the Garden State, thanks to the virtual learning technology that was implemented during the pandemic. If a bill that has cleared its first huddle now in the legislature eventually becomes law, it would allow schools to transition to a remote schedule in the event of a weather emergency, effectively killing the traditional snow day in the Garden State. Rutgers, meanwhile, has agreed to pay out $5 million to settle a lawsuit over virtual instruction during the pandemic. A parent initially brought the suit complaining they paid full tuition for an in-person learning experience, but his daughter was stuck with Zoom classes and had no face-to-face instruction from her professors. However, that $5 million isn't going to go far. More than 64,000 students will share that settlement. That amounts to about $63 per student, barely enough to cover the cost of one book. Rutgers in-state tuition averages about $15,000 per year. The New Jersey State Supreme Court has essentially solidified Democratic hold of New Jersey's congressional districts for the next decade. Justices rejected a Republican lawsuit to have the new map of congressional districts thrown out. The radically gerrymandered boundaries now give Democrats solid control of 9 of 12 districts. Only 2 Republican districts remain, and only one is considered competitive, the 7th district that is currently held by Democrat Tom Malinowski. New Jersey is the worst state in which to retire. That probably doesn't come as much of a surprise to you, but now it is quantified in a new WalletHub survey that took a look at 47 metrics of retiree friendliness, and that's where New Jersey ranks dead last. The state taxes pensions and Social Security, has no special tax breaks for seniors. It was also no surprise that Florida is the best state to retire, while New Jersey was last. That was one of the reports that we talked about last night on Access New Jersey. Ken Kamen from Mercadian Asset Management was my guest, and we talked about things that you need to be thinking about in order to secure a sound financial future for your retirement, whether it was your 401k allocations or other things that you need to consider. You can see a rebroadcast of that program and hear Ken's advice at nj1015.com, on our Facebook page, and our YouTube channel. Valuable information to help you ask the right questions in order to ensure a solid retirement. When we say we're number one in New Jersey, it's usually tongue-in-cheek because we've finished dead last in some category. But that got our Jeff Dominski starting to think, especially with a dispute over pizza with the governor of Connecticut. So Jeff is listing all of the ways that New Jersey is better than every other state in the nation. You can check out his state-by-state list at nj1015.com and on our Facebook page. and certainly add your own. If you have something to say about our top stories, you can leave your comments right here. Please like and share this video. And remember, we're always taking your calls talking Jersey on air on New Jersey 101.5. I'm Eric Scott. That's New Jersey's First News for this Friday, February 4th. Have a great weekend.